Seems like everybody has been out and about today trying to enjoy that fresh, warm air. But the nice weather is already causing problems for some homeowners. KCCI's Cynthia Fodor shows us. Cynthia.
Stacy, take a look at this. Today's massive meltdown on top of all of our frozen ground is creating flooded yards like this.
This sign in the Ames neighborhood says lot for sale, but look at the lot. It looks like a lake for sale. Houses on quiet residential streets now are waterfront properties. Birds are singing and the snow is screaming as it melts away. Winter headed down the drain. A beautiful sound, but not always a pretty sight, with yards frozen solid for months, suddenly filling up like ponds.
Just going to have a in-ground swimming pool this year, I think. It'll take all summer for it to dry up.
Michael Olgren is digging a trench for the water to flow faster.
Well, we got a river going now.
A whole lot of flooding going on.
At True Value, folks loading up on ice melt a few days ago are now carrying out sandbags to direct flooding away from foundations. You can see how water corroded the siding here.
Yeah, we're getting a lot of basement leakage going on. We just see a lot of people having to seep into their basement because a lot of that ice builds up against the house.
So what do you do? Joe Bergeson suggests using push brooms, wet vacs, and sump pumps like this that hook up to a garden hose.
It sucks through the bottom of the pump so you can just set it in the water and it'll pump it away from where you wouldn't want to go with it and move it out somewhere down the yard.
At the Olgrens, the water's moving down the yard on its own.
And it'll all just run right back into there,
which is
the backyard. And it'll turn into another swimming pool. Gotta love Iowa.
Now, I checked with the National Weather Service this afternoon and was told the ground is frozen down nearly 3 feet, and it will be at least mid-April before the ground frost is thawed. Stacy?
That's a long time to hang in there when you've got a water problem. Cynthia, thank you.